बिफोर स्टार्टिंग आई वुड लाइक टू से वन प्रेयर. सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः, सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः, सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु, मा कश्चित् दुःखं.
Dr. Sandhya Parecha ji is the performing academician. She is the dancer, she is the choreographer, author, a scholar, a researcher, senior most disciple of late Guru Acharya Parvati Kumar ji. And she has also done her doctorate, the research in Natyashastra. Name few of them. The Lifetime Achievement Award she has bagged. She has bagged Sangeet Natak Academy Award. She is also founder, principal, and managing trustee of the college, which is under the management of her own NGO, Sarfoji Raje Bhosle Center, Mumbai.
You never really know the true value of a moment until it becomes memory. So today what I'm going to give you are my real memories, because those moments I have lived, and those memories are making what I am today. Because life is full of possibilities, one which always challenges you, and with that challenges it changes you also, because you learn a lot out of it. So
Yes, ma'am.
that's how the life takes you, and my dance revolved in my life right from the age 3, because my father was fond of dancing, because my father taught my mother also dance in 1920s, 30s, 40s. I'm talking about in those
Oh.
years. My mother had learned dance, my father had learned dance, and my father was very fond of dancers. So as soon as after my birth, immediately he took me to the Bal Bhavan Chowpatty, and there Ramesh Guru over there. He was teaching a folk master, was teaching folk dances, and I my sister both started learning folk dance under a guru. Sincerity and interest, he took me to his guru, Acharya Parvati Kumarji, and he refused to take me down. He said, no, she's a very young girl, I will not teach her. I'm talking
At
about
the age of three.
17. No, that was the age of, say, 6, 7, around 6, 7. He said, no.
Okay. All right.
Then 3, 4 years, 5 years, I used to go with Ramesh Puroji to Guruji's place. He used to doing some choreography, or he's teaching some student. I used to go there, I used to sit there, I used to watch it. Meanwhile, I used to participate in all the school functions, all the programs. And once in sixth standard, I think Guruji told that, why do you want to learn dancing? And I answered that I want to learn dance because I want to become a guru like you, and also I want to make a very huge college of dance. And so how I gave answer, I don't know, but I gave this answer. And on that Guru Purnima, Guruji told me that, okay, I will teach her, I will start her dancing, Bharatanatyam training. So you bring her on a Guru Purnima day. It's auspicious day in India. So the first shloka he gave me was from the Bhagavad Gita. Yattad agre visham ivam pariname amrutopamam tat sukham satvikam proktam atma buddhi prasadajam. I was not having a Sanskrit in school. So what is Sanskrit, I was not knowing. But he told me, you have to learn this by heart, then only I will teach. So I sat there for half an hour. I learned that shloka. I repeated that shloka without knowing the meaning. But the meaning of it was so deep, that what is sattvic, what is pure, what is religious, what is absolutely pure, is which is in the beginning it will be like a poison. And I never understood that he's taking me from the nritya to the nritya yoga. The nritya yoga or the natya yoga is absolutely a different world together altogether. What is a yoga means? Yoga is a Sanskrit word which is derived from a Sanskrit word root, yuja. Yuja, which means to join, to yoke, or to unite. To unite is the real aim of the yoga, to unite with the self-realization, to self, with the self, to overcome all kinds of sufferings and living everything and reaching to the state of mind, to the liberation, to the moksha,
Okay.
or to the kaivalya. And so what is kaivalya? What is moksha? All this is beyond the understanding, once you understand the sattvic sukha, once you understand taking that poison, those bad things first, I mean, say too much rigorous practice. People will say, how can you do 10 hours of practice a day, 12 hours practice? Why? You do your education, you do other things. There are a lot many other things to do. Really, if you want to reach to that target, if you really want to reach to that, the karma yoga, that is a kriya yoga, is a must. Then comes is the bhakti yoga. The bhakti yoga is a religious dedication, the shraddha and saburi. I'm saying, means you unite the self with the absolute self. In the religious matter, as that the individual soul is going to be unite with the infinite soul. At the psychologically level, you are going to be integrated your personality, where no longer cross perception will be left out. You are very firm, you know what you want. That's the psychologically yoga. And emotionally also, there is very important point, is telling the waves of likes and dislikes. You just away from that likes and dislikes, which permits oneself with the absolutely within yourself, and to know yourself whether you are right or wrong. When the dancer achieves the technique, a particular technical things, you know, I did particular composition, I did Javi, I did Padam, I did Alari, I enjoyed and forget. And beyond that, you don't understand the life of a nritya or the life of a dancer is beyond that. Because there are so many dancers in the world tell you that we live dancing. What do you mean by we live dancing? We live dancing, it means that the dance itself gives you so much happiness, so much pleasure. We don't dance for the audience only. We don't dance for the God only. We dance for ourselves. Forgetfulness achieves the bliss, which is called the Paramananda. And this Paramananda, very first dance of the Nataraja, is also known as Ananda Tandava. The Tandava, the Nataraja Nritya, is known as Ananda Tandava, which is Satchit Anandam, which is going to give you the Param Anandam. So the final achievement by which the yoga or yogi himself, or yogi he brings it. I'm saying, who is Nataraja? He's the yogi's yogi. He's the God's God. And he's the super yogi. Brings the body and soul together, and her earth and the sky together, and brings out the world to salvation and blessings us with the liberation of the pain, fatigue, sorrow, everything. And these virtues are from the beginning given via dancing. So learning an Indian classical dance is just not learning a dance, it is learning the way of life, a way of making a good human being. Before the journey, I would like to say the Kalidasa in Malavika Agni Mitram, he says that Traigunyo Bhava Atra Loka Charitram Nana Rasam Drushyate Natyam Bhinna Ruchir Janasya Baudha Api Ekam Samaradhanam. The Natya or a Nritya is those art form which are arrived or derived from these three gunas, Sattva Gunas, Raja Guna and Tamo Gunas, which includes all nine rasas, including the Shanta Rasa, which includes and which satisfies everyone's wishes. Somebody likes the Las, someone likes the Tandav, somebody likes the Raudra, somebody likes the Shanta. So it is the combination of all this thing which is leading the artist, not only the artist, not only the Rasikas, but the whole world is changing with the positivity of this Indian dance. In during this process of my life, you will be shocked that my Guruji never stopped me taking part in films. I have participated in Vishantaram's film. I have participated in the drama. So I'm a Best Child Actress awardee from the government of Maharashtra. When fashion show during those times was a very popularly fashion shows, Russian ballet dancing. You say, what not?
Okay.
Along with, so it was not, the process was that to make you know everything. And then at one moment, he made me perform 15 shows of Durga Zali Gauri, one of the children ballet which he choreographed.
Mm-hmm.
And it was on a peak when he told me that you have to stop it. And I felt like, yeah, I'm taking a poison. So I said, I was on a peak dancer. I was a main role dancer. And how can Guruji tell me not to perform? Because that time, I do remember Shashi Kapoorji had come for the 50th show and he appraised me a lot. So I said, no chances. And he said, no, you're not going to perform. And then he started the one of the most important project of his life was the 324 shlokas of Nandikeshwara's Abhinay Darpanam, which is known as
a textbook of
Bharatanatyam. Yes, Bharatanatyam. And 5 years, morning 9 to evening 10, I was with Guruji and having a breakfast, everything, and he used to take the shlok out, every shlok, every word we used to take it out, and the root, every word's root we used to go, and we used to take out the etymological meaning, and then he choreographed, then he set up the music, and the whole thing, 324 shlokas, took 6 years to choreograph, and it was first performing ICCR Delhi, and then Krishna Gana Sabha in 1986, and it was the biggest hit. And proudly I could say that I am the sole dancer today also that nobody has challenged this performing all 324 shlokas in audiovisual form of this particular text of the 12th century AD. But when they forced me, I surrendered it and I bowed down to them and I went to the Sanskrit guru and I learned Sanskrit, the Bhakti Yoga. The Bhakti Yoga. Then this is a Jnana Yoga. The Jnana Yoga is a very, very difficult task. Because Jnana Yoga, to take Jnana, my Guruji was not a very simple person. If one shloka he will take, he will not be happy with one word, with one translation or one meaning. If I take out 2, 3, 4 meaning, he said only this much, only 4 meaning.
He'll keep on exploring and exploring.
So exploring means if you tell me, today also I have all my books, if you say a Brahma word, I have got minimum 72 pages written on Brahma. Today, I can show you that book.
That is the main research what you do.
Correct. Mm. That is the way he wanted us to learn. And that is the yoga, a real Jnana Yoga. Because Jnana Ki Ganga, you just float into you. It's spirituality and dance yoga. If you don't combine it, you really will not reach to the Raja Yoga.
Reach to that point where you should.
The divine, the divineness to understand, to understand and to feel that oneness, one needs to understand this. So I was here, my journey went to that Abhinay Darpanam. After Abhinay Darpanam, while learning Abhinay Darpanam only, I wanted to pay my fees because we were not that rich. Yeah. So I said, can I start teaching, earning and earn and learn? He was so broad-minded at that time in 80s, 81, he told me, yes, you can start your class. But, beta, moh mat karna. And so what is moh? I said, how can be a moh? Why do you attach to your student? I mean, you can't attach to your student. I said, okay, that I can do it easily. That was the very simple answer I gave. But as you grow in teaching, and 81, I started my Kala Parichay in two branches, one in Grantor and one in Dadar. Then slowly, we gradually, all over Bombay, we do Moha. And that is really a very touchy moment, which I just now told you, this moment, when they become memory, you really enjoy it, you really relish it.
Actually, ma'am, now I am able to connect with you about the Moha part. So I have my students as well, and when I was leaving them, I was so attached, although I just taught them for 2 years or so, I was so attached that I was not able to leave them.
But yes, Moha Tyag Karke, what he taught me was to teach them and to train them in the various virtues like honesty, kindness, hard work, patience, compassion, loyalty, fairness, tolerance, and abhyas, abhyas, abhyas. Go on learning whatever you learn. You become a doctor, you become whatever you want to become, but don't leave your study.
Not even in the art form, but in any profession you go.
Absolutely. You, whatever you are doing, you should not stop studying. You are a student. Once you know that you are a student, whole of your life is very easy for you to understand and to settle down. When you become a teacher, when you become a guru, when you become, I'm saying, so many other egos or nuances or something which enters in your mind and you just ruin your life. So first thing is to remain, at the 94, he was on a bed and he said, I'm a senior student, you are a junior student. Okay, tell me what you have taught today to your student. So at the 94 also, he was a senior student. So that gives you a lesson that you should be an eternal student, will really give you a great happiness to reach to the ultimate goal of Raja Yoga.
And then, so basically, you cannot stop learning at any point of time in your life.
Absolutely, absolutely. And there are so many. There is one more shloka from the Bhagavad Gita: Swadharmam Nidhanam Shroya Paradharmo Bhayavaha. It means your own dharma you should not leave. There are so many girls. 10 years I've learned Bharatanatyam. Now I want to learn dance, Kathak. They learn 3-4 years Kathak. They will leave. I'm sorry. Your dharma, you have chosen it to become a Bharatanatyam dancer. How can you learn in 2 years or 4 years or 5 years? The first joy student should understand is to not to lie. When I ask the student sometime that you have learned this or you have not, and some student very frankly, boldly say, no, I have not done. And I praise them and I tell them why you are good, because you are very good hearted. You should keep your heart this way. And the other students, when they cry, that time I have to take them separately and make them understand that you should not lie. Then they say, you know, my mummy told me, say this, and I told you. So that time you feel it bad that when these parents, it is the society which needs to be more bold. And some situations it happens that you are not wrong. And still you have to say sorry. That also you have to teach. One of the very beautiful experience of my life, 86, when I told you that we performed Abhinaya Darpanam, world's biggest show. We did it and beautiful performance, 2, 3, 4 performances we did in Delhi, Chennai, all those things. And then we came back, and that those time was there when there was Asia was there, and all these zonal center were established, and zonal center where opening was going on. And one of the zonal center invited, they called me, Sandhya, you come and perform. You are perform Abhinaya Darpan. I was very excited, and I went to Guruji and I said, Guruji, I would like to perform because I'm invited. So he said, you are invited, go and perform. Whose Abhinaya Darpan is whose production? And I was like, oh, it's my mistake. How can I say that it's my production? It's your production, Guruji. So he said, okay, I will tell the authority to write a letter. And those time was a telegram. Timing. So it was a telegram which came to Guruji, and Guruji received the telegram. He said, no, I'm not going to do the, because I've not now given away this production to the Indian National Theatre, INT. So then I got so upset. I said, how can Guruji do this to me? And I was upset, and I said, no, I'm not going to talk to the organizer again. He said, just get out of the house. And that was my last day. Like you said, you're not supposed to come to my house. And it was in, I think it was 88 to 92 years of my life. I used to go to Guruji's house morning 9 to 9. He never used to talk to me. He used to ask me, hey, book nikalo, you just take out this meaning, write this. He used to teach all other students, but not to me. When you are in a Guru Shishya Parampara, you must understand that there are some points where you have to surrender. You cannot bring your ego out and say, I will not do it. I would have done it, which I realized very later. I would have done it and let the organizer say no instead of me saying no. And after that, in 90s, of course, my Kala Parichay was there. Then I established my NGO. I started doing the Arangetram of my students. Again, when I was doing Arangetram of my student, he said, nothing doing, I will not allow you to do Arangetram like this. You must write a write-up. Every Arangetram, you must write a write-up. And I was like, oh my God. And I started writing a write-up like dance and sculpture, dance and painting, dance and literature, dance and various topics. I started researching and started writing. And it itself became a research-oriented thesis for me. And in 95 onwards, I started doing my PhD work and achieved my PhD on Angika Abhinaya in Bharatanatyam through the ancient Sanskrit treatises, which is published by Bhavans, and the first volume is all over. We are coming out in second. I've got a friend of mine, Bhavna Thai, we call it Bhavna Thai. So there is a combo of Sandhya Thai and Bhavna Thai. So if Sandhya Thai is angry, it is a Bhavna Thai who pacifies. If Bhavna Thai is angry, it is a Sandhya Thai pacifies. So it's a very beautiful combination in the institute where the students are always, always protected. So it is like a Nari Kela Samakara Drishyate Api Sajjana. The Sajjanas are always like a coconut, hard from outside and from very sweet and
tender from inside.
Tender from inside. Guru Kumbhar or Shishya Ghat, Ghat Ghat Kaade Khot, Antara Hath Sahara Deth Bahar Mare Chot. It's like a pot. It's like a mud pot. The guru is really preparing and making that pot and giving a good shape to that pot. So he's giving a putting from outside with the wet, but from inside he's putting his hand so that it should not break. The same way, I'm saying, that anger is like it's like a Kumbhara's bat of the earthen pot makers.
All right. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so ma'am, just a small question. So when you were performing in so many festivals and when you bagged so many awards, also the national award, so did you feel, did you have that feeling of pride?
A very important question you have asked me. I will remember, I have a very good memory of my life. This is, I think, Jhansi Festival. And we were invited, and very nicely, the very top IS officer, IPS officer, all of them called, and very nicely, we reached there, middle of the night, we reached because the train was delayed, and they took us to some khandar place where there was no gadda, takya, there was no water. And I called the people and I tried calling the people, the authorities, I started from the watchmen to the bosses, to the highest level. And unfortunately, it happened that till morning, 6-7 o'clock, we were not settled down. And I was with a group of 40 to 50 people. We were supposed to present the Bhagavad Gita. Before the program, I told them to give me a mic. I took the mic, I did the announcement, I did announce the name of the authorities. I said, this is unfair to call an artist and do like that. You must be having a difficulties. You must be having some problems. But the artist is also, and so that time I remember my guru. Guru always tells me that you should be passionate, you should be careful, you should be silent, but you should be fighting for your own rights. And that completely...
You should be speaking for your own self.
Yes. And that speech was spread all over. And I think within 24 hours, the authority was set. And so that is the power of the artist. You should tolerate, bear with it, and when you find that there is no chance you can talk directly to the authorities, or there are no people who are coming to you, then it is an open statement which is going to make you, make the authorities aware. So I think after that, I have never seen, I wrote six, seven, eight books on dance. There are four more coming out in this year, hopefully. And I, as promised by Guruji, I have started my college affiliated to Kalidas, Sanskrit University, Ramtek, Nagpur. And we give BA, MA in Bharatanatyam and Kathak. We are also
I was exactly coming to that, ma'am.
Right.
That is the only school for dance.
Yes.
So in school, college for dance.
Yes, so, college for dance was... and it is preserving and propagating the Guru Shishya Parampara. I say Guru Shishya Parampara, if you have your own Guru and if you want to do a practical part from it, you can really do it from your Guru and also go ahead with the education. So it's such a beautiful concept which was accepted by Kalidas University, and we are now doing, we are also now a research center. So
at Edgenus, we focus on the Guru Shishya Parampara, and we value it so much because the right Guru should reach the right student and the artist.
We are non-granted. From last 20 years, my college runs without granting aid from government. It runs on its own only with the fees of the students. Your work will definitely repay. Maybe sometime it is late or too late, but it pays you. That is what my I believe. And this belief have given me two states award, like one Gujarat state award, Maharashtra state award. I got two states award of Maharashtra itself.
Yes,
one for the Sanskrit and one for the one Sanskrit language and one for the dance.
Bharatanatyam.
Also, I got the Sangeet Natak Academy National Award for all over overall contribution in the field of dance. It's just not for the Bharatanatyam or Kathak or for, it's overall, like you
okay.
are also a writer, okay. you are a dancer, you are a researcher, so it's overall. So you feel it very good when you are acknowledged by a nation, by your own state. And the foremost is when your students tells you that they love you.
Yes, ma'am. And many of your students have joined us over the live, and they express their love for you.
You really feel awarded when your students tells that you, they have imbibed something from you, they have learned something from you, and then they pass it on, this thing, passing it on to the next generation. And so this is the tradition or the parampara which really makes you, feels you very, very happy and satisfied and most successful in the life.
Okay, ma'am, last but not least, so I would want you to share your thoughts to the young generation who has just begun their career in any art form.
No, instead of art form, let me put it this way. Any good human being, if you want to become, for the beautiful eyes, look for the good things in all other people. Look
for
all other people. For the beautiful lips, speak only the words of kindness, and walk with the knowledge that you are never alone, and never alone. Gnyan Ganga ko saath leke chalo, so you are never alone.
So we are so, so grateful that you came here to our platform and we could connect.